subscribe now and press the bell icon. Never miss an update.
Hello guys, today I am going to show you how to model and analyze raw foundation with drop to reduce punching shear ratio using the ACI318 code. If you want to learn AutoCAD from the beginning, then you have to look at this YouTube channel of CAD Smith. I will drop the link of this channel in the description of my video. After analyze the ETAPS model and export the reactions from ETAPS 9.7 to save version 12. For exports reactions from ETAPS to save, first analyze the ETAPS model. After analyze, go to file, export, and save story as save version 12.f2k text file. Now select the base story to export and choose export floor loads and loads from above, and select the all load patterns which we define in ETAPS model. Select the location where you want to save the file. Now in save, go to file, import save.f2k file and select .f2k text file which you export from ETAPS model. First, we are defining the material properties. 3 KSI concrete strength for the foundation and 4 KSI for the retaining wall. Go to define materials, and this is a 4 KSI concrete strength material property. For defining a 3 KSI concrete strength, click on add new material quick, select the material type to concrete and specification of FC prime 3000 PSI. Defining soil subgrade property, we have a bearing capacity of 2.5 TSF. We have a formula of subgrade modulus in pound per foot cube is equal to 12 into safety factor into bearing capacity. So it is 2.5 into 2.2046 into 1000 into 36. In the value of 36, there is a safety factor of 3. So for defining soil subgrade property, go to define soil subgrade property. Input the value of subgrade modulus by starting a is equal to sign. Now let's check the load combos. It will be the same because we imported the model from ETAPS. So go to define load combinations. This is a service load combo of 1.0 dead load plus 1.0 live load. This is a seismic load combo of 1.2 dead load plus 1 live load minus 1 earthquake. This is also a seismic load combo of 0.9 dead load minus earthquake. Go to design preferences, and according to ACI 318 code, we have a clear cover top and clear cover bottom is 3 inches for the foundation. Go to design combos and check the design load combinations for the design of foundation. Now defining a slab property, go to define slab properties and defining a 33 inch mat foundation. Select the slab material of 3 KSI and thickness of 33 inch and the mat foundation type. And uncheck the thick plate option. So let's start the mat foundation modeling. Go to draw and draw slabs area. Now select the slab area which we draw and go to edit area, expand shrink area and expand the area to 6 inches as we have the retaining wall thickness of 12 inches. Select the slab area, go to Assign, Support Data, Soil Property, and select the 2.5 TSF soil subgrade property which we defined. Press Shift plus F4 to open Show Loads option. Right click on the point, go to the tab of Load. These are the loads exported from the ETAPS model. After modeling the rough foundation, we are proceeding for the analysis and design. In analysis, we have to check the deflection and the soil pressure of the rough foundation, and the deflection should be less than allowable limit and the soil pressure should be less than allowable soil capacity. In the design procedure, we have to check the punching ratio should be less than 1.0, and then we proceed for the reinforcement design. Go to Run Analysis and Design. After analyzing, go to Display, Show Deform Shape. Select the load combination to service load. This is the deform shape of rough foundation. We have to check here the deflection should be less than allowable limit given in the soil report. In this case, we get the minimum deflection of -0.349 inch and the maximum deflection equal to -0.003 inches. You can check the minimum and maximum deflection value at the bottom left screen of Safe Software. For soil pressure check, go to Display, Show Reaction Forces. Select the load combination to service load and the type of reaction soil pressure. This is the soil pressure contour of rough foundation. We have a soil pressure limit of 5511.5 lb/ft² In our case, we get minimum of -573.38 lb/ft² and a maximum of -58.02 lb/ft² soil pressure. You can check these values at bottom left screen of Safe Software. When you move the cursor on the contours, it will show the soil pressure value. Let's check the slab forces. Go to Display, Slab Forces, Stresses. Choose M11 option for the service load combination. This is M11 diagram of the rough foundation in the contour form. Here you can check the value of the M11 by moving the cursor on the contours. Let's check the M22 moment for the service load combination. Now this is showing the M22 moment of the service load combination. For punching check, go to Display, Show Punching Shear Design. These are the values of punching shear capacity ratios, which should be less than 1.0. But look at this, these values are almost greater than 1. So it is all fail in the punching ratio. It means 33 inch rough foundation have not enough punching shear capacity to bear the column load. Since punching ratio is more than 1.0, we have to increase mat thickness, or either we provide drop beneath the column to avoid the excessive punching shear capacity ratios. According to ACI 318-14 code, minimum drop panel below slab is equal to 1/4 into slab thickness, and drop panel should extend L/6 from column support to each side, where L is equal to center to center distance between support. So in our case, mat thickness is equal to 33 inches, minimum drop panel below slab is equal to 33/4, which get the value 8.25 inch. So we will provide at least 42 inches drop, and the center to center distance between support is equal to 27 feet. So drop panel extend on each side is equal to 26/6, which get the value of 4.5 feet on each side of the column. For defining drop, go to Define, Slab Properties, Add New Property. Now we are defining a drop panel of 45 inch. Select the property type to drop and uncheck the thick plate. Select the 3 KSI for the slab material. Similarly, we are defining a drop panel of 48 inch thick. Now we are defining a drop panel of 51 inch thick. Defining a drop panel of 54 inch thick. And defining a drop panel of 60 inch thick. As we calculated earlier, we have to increase the drop panel size to 4.5 feet from support to each side. Go to draw points. Input the offset X and Y value to 4.5 feet so that point will draw 4.5 feet from support to each side. For drop in raw formation, go to draw rectangular slabs area. Now select the property D45 and draw the drop at the location of the points which we draw. Since the drop panel size is the same, so we are replicating the drop. Select the drop, go to edit, replicate and input the increment DX value to 26 feet. Look at this, the drop panel replicated 26 feet away from the drop panel which we selected. Now similarly, we are replicating the drop panels in the Y direction. Select the drop panel, go to edit, replicate and give the increment DY value. Select the drop panel, go to edit, replicate and give the increment DY value to -24.25 feet. Now again select the drop panels, go to edit, replicate and give the increment DY value to -26 feet. Now selecting the drop panels again and go to edit, replicate and the increment DY value to -15.75 feet. After run analysis checking the punching share ratio, some of the column location is still getting punching ratio more than 1.0, so we will increase the drop thickness till it's less than 1.0. After increasing the drop thicknesses so that its punching ratio will be less than 1.0, now see all drop panels have punching share ratio is less than 1.0. In the next video, we will discuss about the reinforcement design of rough foundation with drop in foundation. If you like my video, please share and don't forget to subscribe and press the bell icon so that you will never miss any update.